Coming up on this Wednesday morning edition of Daily Iowan TV, we give you the rundown on Monica Lewinsky's lecture addressing cyberbullying.
And later we'll show you how one music group turns trash into treasure.
I think it has to do with what the opera is basing itself on, which is everyday life. And in everyday life, we might come across any of the objects that you would find on stage.
We have more updates for you on how Iowa football will be preparing to take on Minnesota here at Kinnick this upcoming Saturday.
And we'll take a closer look at how the Iowa volleyball team did this past weekend.
And find out what this Halloween weekend will be like in weather.
All that and more coming right up.
Don't go anywhere. Daily Iowan TV starts right now.
Good morning and thank you for tuning in. I'm Mackenzie Cooper.
And I'm Cole Johnson. Last night, Monica Lewinsky came to speak at the Iowa Memorial Union. Her speech entitled The Price of Shame was part of the UI lecture series. Lewinsky's speech discussed cyberbullying and living in the public eye for many years. She also touched on her recent public speaking at multiple conferences.
At the age of 22, I fell in love with my boss. And at the age of 24, I learned the devastating consequences. Today, you're looking at a woman who had been publicly silent for a decade. Obviously, that's changed, but it was really only in the past few years. After breaking my self-imposed public exile with a first-person essay in Vanity Fair, I gave my first major public talk at the Forbes 30 Under 30 Summit.
Those in attendance were not able to record or take any photographs during the duration of her speech, and media organizations in attendance were only allowed to record the first 3 minutes of her speech. Attendees were able to have a Q&A with Lewinsky after she finished her lecture. Be sure to take a look at dailyiowan.com for more on the event.
The University of Iowa physician and scientist will participate in two congressional briefings today. Michael Abramoff is the founder of an early-stage medical diagnostics company and a key researcher here at the university. The congressional briefings are organized by the Science Coalition, a nonprofit, nonpartisan organization dedicated to sustainable federal investment in scientific research to showcase how research-based companies that were started at universities are contributing to society and stimulating the economy. University of Iowa President Bruce Harreld weighed in on the hearing saying, quote, "In order to continue improving society, we need to keep investing in basic science research," end quote.
As part of the continuation of the LGBTQ History Month, the University of Iowa LGBTQ Resource Center held a drag queen story time so a couple local queens could tell their personal stories. Both drag queens seen here have been performing at Studio 13 in Iowa City for around a year now and have become fixtures to Iowa City nightlife and LGBTQ culture. After sharing their experiences, the two answered questions from the audience. Drag queen Fantasia Wood was asked what advice she has for aspiring drag queens.
I would definitely say to find out who you've always wanted to be, who, like, what's your fantasy, and fulfill that. You know, don't go out looking to be someone else. Be something that you create in the creativity of your own mind.
The campus activities board held an especially colorful event yesterday afternoon at the Iowa Memorial Union. Students could visit a tie-dye station set up in the Hawkeye Room. The event was in partnership with the Cultural and Resource Center in honor of LGBTQ History Month. T-shirts, gloves, hats, and headbands could be dipped into a variety of different paint colors. CAB does these make-and-take events on the first and third Tuesday of every month. However, CAB workers said tie-dye is always one of their most popular crafts.
We're also pairing with the Cultural and Resource Centers and raising awareness for LGBTQ History Month, so we have some flyers down at the end. This is just an event we do on the first and third Tuesday of every month, and we always do a different thing.
Well, that seems like a great event. Kenzie, how are you feeling about the cold temperatures? It's been quite a change recently. How are you feeling about it?
Yeah, definitely. I'm not a fan, but I mean, it's typical Iowa fall and winter.
Definitely.
So let's toss it over to Joe in the weather studio to find more.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Well, Kenzie,
you're going to continue to see those cold temperatures, so sorry about that. But Wednesday afternoon, we're looking at mostly sunny skies with a high of about 60 degrees. As we move into the evening hours, though, we're going to see that cold start to creep in with a clear night dropping down to about 39 degrees. Now let's take a look at our five-day extended forecast. Thursday will be partly cloudy with temperatures reaching a high of 64 degrees. For the most part, the coming Halloween weekend is going to be a cloudy one. Friday, we'll see partly cloudy sky with a temperature reaching up to the high 40s. Saturday, expect to see some rain showers out there with a high of 43 degrees. Sunday, expected to be mostly cloudy with highs reaching in the 46 degrees. As we come out of the weekend, on Monday, we're going to continue to see those cloudy skies with a high of 50 degrees. And guys, that's your weather for the week. Back to you.
Thanks, Joe. Many people may consider trashes as rejected and useless objects. However, a Chicago-based experimental music group is making the exception. Daily Iowan TV reporter Junyo Kim has more on it.
Trash, people, and space. Those are basic elements they need. Last Sunday, Aperiodic performed Time with People composed by Tim Parkinson, also known as Trash Opera, at Foxman Music Building.
You'd think that these are obviously trashes. However, when it comes to Time with People, they become musical instruments, background, and components of theater arts.
Aperiodic is a Chicago-based performance collective featuring post-Cajun notated acoustic and experimental music. Tim Parkinson, a British composer of Time with People, redefined the fundamentals of opera from its 16th century origins and reconceived from elements of 21st century post-historical culture.
Time with People is exactly what the title says. It is some time with some people. And the opera itself has the performers doing various actions, activities that anybody would do in their life.
This non-traditional opera challenges audience to reconsider their preconceived notions of the nature of music.
It's to be both like part of something and to be like the separated and isolated individual. So there's a lot of fun and playfulness in it.
Also, it might have changed audience's perception and awareness of trashes.
In this sense, trash is sometimes regarded as non-valuable, but this performance has us engaging with this same trash as valuable objects for making music, for making sound, exploring the potential of objects that are being rejected.
Reporting from Foxman Music Building, this is Junyo Kim of Daily Iowan TV.
Well, that's definitely an interesting way to make some music.
Yes, I definitely agree. That's something that I could probably even do. I'm not the most musically gifted, so let's toss it over to Lucy and Beau in the sports studio to find out more.
That's right. This weekend, the Iowa football team is taking on Minnesota in what's supposed to be a pretty good game. It's always fun to see the Hawks and Gophers battle it out.
Yeah, I don't know about this game, though, but I'm a big P.J. Fleck fan, who's the head coach of Minnesota, so I'm excited to see him. But even though the Hawkeyes have not had the season the team has expected, they still have to move on with a positive outlook on their future. Mary-Kate Harrion has more.
Now 4-3, with all of the Hawkeyes' dreams of going to the Big Ten championship game gone, they will now play for the Floyd Trophy and hope to get that spark for the rest of the season.
We still got three trophy games left, and we got one this weekend. So we talk about how big those games are. And, you know, just the seniors, you know, leaving the jersey in a better place, that's enough motivation.
You definitely have to stay positive. No, come back to work ready to go. You can't let the old stuff carry over, you know, into this Minnesota game week. So we're just coming to work and trying to have a good attitude and good approach.
Motivation is just one game at a time, get better. And if we do that, we're gonna win games. That's what we need to do.
You need to win. If you're any type of competitor, you want to win. You don't want to just sit down, lay back, and just get your butt kicked. So you got to come out every week, prepare, and just win games, and things will fall. I mean, yeah, obviously it's a trophy game, so this is obviously a rivalry, so it's exciting. You know, we want to get out there and get a win in Kinnick under the lights.
Just focus on the same thing we focus on all year, and that's just playing our best football. Obviously, you know, we haven't been able to get that done. you know, a couple times throughout the year, but that's the goal right now, is we're just trying to improve. We're just trying to play our absolute best on Saturday.
The Hawkeyes will be back inside of Kinnick Stadium this Saturday at 5:30 as they take on the Minnesota Gophers. Reporting outside of the Iowa football facility, this has been Mary-Kate Herrien for Daily Iowan TV Sports.
Mary-Kate and Zach Mackey will be back in the studio Friday morning to break down Iowa's matchup with Minnesota during their pregame show.
The Iowa men's golf team traveled to Dallas on Monday to compete in the Royal Oaks Intercollegiate Tournament. The team took five golfers to take on the competition down south.
I'm sure that warmer October weather was nice, but they weren't really looking for a nice tan, but they were looking for their golfers to place high. Iowa had three golfers who placed within the top 30, Benton Weinberg, Matthew Walker, and Sam Murray. Alex Shockey was only a few places behind them, earning himself a 38th place finish in the tournament.
Weinberg led the Hawks with a career-best 54-hole score of 212 and tied for 17th place, his first top 20 finish this season. Matthew Walker tied for 26th place with a 54-hole score of 215.
The team placed 7th in the match overall, and thanks to Weinberg's top 20 finish, the Hawks were only two strokes away from a top 5 finish. Iowa was happy with the success they had walking away from Royal Oaks and will find themselves having a bit of a break until they play again. Big Ten match play will start this February in Palm Coast, Florida.
The Iowa women's volleyball team traveled out of state this past weekend to take on two Big Ten rivals. The Hawks fell to the University of Illinois 2-3 on Friday, but came back against Northwestern on Saturday with a clean sweep. Delaney Parker has more on the weekend.
Iowa volleyball is heading into another weekend full of Big Ten matchups. The Hawks will travel to Ann Arbor to take on Michigan on Friday and then travel to Michigan State on Saturday.
Definitely nice getting a 3-0 win against Northwestern and tough loss against Illinois, but we're ready to bounce back from that again and go on with this weekend.
And Michigan State is really, they're big and they're known for their size, and so I think it'll be important for us to just be able to use our shots and be able to hit high and use their block as an advantage to us.
Michigan State, they're a very good serving team. They have really powerful serves behind it, but I'm very confident in our serve receive to be able to pass me good balls.
The Hawks were able to bounce back after a tough loss against Illinois this past weekend with a clean sweep against Northwestern, and they will try to use that momentum heading into the weekend. Reporting for Iowa Volleyball, this has been Delaney Parker, Daily Iowan TV Sports.
The Hawkeyes will travel to Michigan this upcoming weekend to take on two more Big Ten rivals, the Wolverines and the Michigan State Spartans.
That's it for us in the sports studio. However, be sure to tune in tomorrow for what will be the first courtside show for Iowa basketball this season.
Mary-Kate Herrien and Zach Mackey will be here to give you all the updates on how the team has been preparing for their season opener and what fans can expect to look for. Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Bo and Lucy. Each Wednesday, we here at Daily Iowan TV are proud to bring in the ICAC Animal of the Week. This is reserved for that one special animal at the Animal Care and Adoption Center who is ready to meet their new family.
That's right, Cole. This week, we have a dog who probably has one of the best smiles that I have seen in a long time. This is Ruby. She's a pit mix who is somewhere between 3 to 6 years old.
That smile is more than just show, though. Ruby is one of the friendliest day dogs that the ICAC is currently housing. She is super sociable and will play with any toy or anybody, even children.
Ruby already has some training knowing the commands for sit, down, and shake. Given her temperament, she can adjust to any household, though extra obedience classes are recommended to help strengthen the bonds between her and her new family. She even has a voucher for discounted classes.
For more information on them and other animals, please visit the ICAC website, call them at their phone number, or just stop by for a visit.
And, I mean, I might have to go pick her up.
Yeah, she seems really cute.
Yeah, she's really, really cute.
Well, maybe I'll swing by later. And that's a wrap on this Wednesday morning edition of Daily Iowan TV.
Be sure to head over to dailyiowan.com for all your latest news between Monday and Friday.
And if that isn't enough of the Daily Iowan for you, be sure to check out today's copy of the print edition on newsstands now. I'm Cole Johnson.
And I'm Mackenzie Cooper. From all of us here at Daily Iowan TV, thanks for watching.
Have a great day, Iowa City. We'll see you back here next time.